think this is your time?
What's up, everybody? PJ Braun, president of Blackstone Labs, Prime Nutrition, Celestial Bodiez,
TT Fan Club, and a new baby fan club, actually. Are we going to talk about the new baby?
We don't have any footage of the new baby yet.
So there's a new baby. Her name is Tater, and she's also president of the Tater Fan Club.
And she is a tiny little sick kitty.
She is sick. And I'm Celeste, CEO of Celestial Bodiez.
We are doing a shorter one, boom. This is a few days in this one, and try to get them out faster. That makes me happy. And we'll see if this makes you guys happy as well. This is going to Wednesday of last week, where my good friend Jason Castaldi and his wife Kristen were in town. This is my longest tenured friend that I grew up with. He's also my financial advisor.
He's my favorite of your friends. Actually, Will's cool too, but Jay is eccentric.
Ross looks so funny over here.
You're on TV. Say hi.
Say hi. Beanie, say hi.
Beanie, say hi.
This is Chris Aaron back here. This is Ryan Burke, who does all our creative writing.
How are you doing?
This is my longest friend that I grew up with, Jake Saldi, and his wife, Kristen.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Fishing partner.
Hi.
Fishing partner, yes.
Episode play.
What's up, man?
What episode was that?
Four, I think.
It was episode four, bro. I just saw it up on the hero.
And then we have. This is my call center.
You know about the call center?
Yep. Call center has expanded quite a bit.
These guys are all awesome.
What's up, Dan?
Ryan before, right? The barber?
Yeah, this is what I said a couple times. I fell off the little glider thing.
Nice to meet you, man.
Yeah, that's right, man.
Yeah.
So this is the Celestial Bodiez side.
Wow. There's
my dad.
Wow.
Good, how are you?
Good, it's good to see you.
You too.
Hey, how are you?
Yay!
How are you?
Thank you.
Raj, this is Celeste.
Oh my God! Nice to meet you. Hi, you're gorgeous.
You know, you say hi.
Gorgeous. Hi.
Hi, Celeste.
I haven't seen you in so long.
I haven't seen
New
you
York.
Guys forever, I know.
You're so tan.
We're tan.
My brother was here with his kids.
You are very tan. Look at you.
Weekend.
Have you been to the beach? Yes. We went to the beach on Sunday. It was very hot. And he got an interesting sunburn on his back.
My dad.
It was my fault though, because I only rubbed the sunblock only to like the top of his back. And then he got burned underneath it where I didn't put it, so it was my fault.
Oh,
he is? You look so much like your dad.
Do you?
Yeah. So we have a huge shoot for the new, so she got a bunch of new
like
releases
a perfect
now.
Mix between the two.
So Celestial Bodiez is doing awesome. So we're in like a awesome like growth phase right now. It's really exciting because this one is basically the business model is the same as Blackstone Labs. And anything that I learned not to do with Blackstone, I fixed.
Yeah, you already knew.
Here,
that's awesome.
Which is cool. It started in a spare bedroom, just like Blackstone Labs, and now we're 2 years in, and she's doing about 220,000 a month now.
It's amazing.
So this year we should hit.
Very proud of you guys. Awesome.
I think this company in a few years will be the biggest company.
Yeah.
This is my long-term project, especially with like everywhere I go now,
what
I'm starting to
doing?
See more and more people in the clothes. We have like this new fabric. It's so good.
Thank you.
This new fabric we have is so good. The girls are going crazy.
That's awesome.
That's always good when he comes into town. He was also in one of the very first Beauty and Braun videos when we went fishing.
While you guys were gone, I went around the office and took tallies and, you know.
I feel like I didn't get a lot of votes. So.
You did it, but I explained to them that you this whole fishing trip was your idea, that you fish a lot, and so that persuaded certain people. You know, Karen knows you though.
Mm-hmm.
Come to find out, actually, I'm pretty sure JR just put, like he said that this is for Karen and didn't even ask her. So that's really JR.
That's kind of cheating.
Yeah. So, you know, it was 11 people participated and you got a few votes and, you know, 90% of them don't even know who you are. So.
Exactly.
What did you catch?
A snook. I caught a snook.
You also had a little Genova. For you guys, and he's got some interesting things going on with a girl that he's been seeing. She's a little unique, as he puts it.
Hey, PJ, what's up, bro?
Oh, boy. What's up, Jason?
What's up,
bro? How are you?
I try to go to New York.
Jason, this is my best friend that I grew up with. Bro? His name is Jason also.
Oh, double
nice
Jason.
To meet you, man. Yeah, and this is his wife, Kristen.
Hi.
The Rich Piana collab, that was awesome.
Your thing with him?
Yeah, I did it with him.
I saw that, and it was good.
How was he? Was he nice to you, Jason?
Yeah, he treated me with respect, at least. Yeah.
You don't let him smack you anymore.
Yes, I'm putting
no,
him on the
he let me smack him.
Oh, good.
I get to smack him back.
They're, okay. They're in the constant. Okay.
So what is your plans for the day, Jason?
Rosalind and Celeste, so you can have those
with a friend
if you want them, but you have to take so good. No, those are hers.
I'm gonna be.
You know what? You
need
those
I'm gonna be. I'm paying. Yeah. I'm
if you want them, you can have them,
but
you have to say thank you so much.
So
do you like these hard ones?
Well, Blackstone is having meals eventually, so I'll take
that. Unfortunately,
are you
on
prep meals? So it'll be a lot easier.
I have to wear those today. It'll be a lot easier to get in shape.
Okay, Jason, let's. You meet me in my office. I'm coming.
Yeah. Sweet, and it's like it's just like steaming.
And give me like 2 minutes, okay?
All right, well. I'm supposed to go to fucking New York and she won't let me go.
You're swearing a lot today. Jeez, you're mad.
I'm mad at my mom, man. She won't let me go to New York, man.
Why is she not letting you go?
Because she's scared, man. I'm not her only child. It's dangerous in New York.
Did you tell Steve?
I told Steve. Steve understands. But Steve says he's going to be down here in 2 weeks. Is that true? Or something. She's ruining my career. You know that, right?
No, she's not. She's absolutely not true, dude. That's your mom. She's looking out for you.
Yeah, but it would have benefited my channel going to New York.
I'm telling you, you're gonna have tons of stuff going on. She's just worried that...
Is New York really dangerous? Be honest with me.
I mean, as far as cities go, it's probably the most dangerous city, I suppose, yeah.
It's not
There's
safe.
Definitely a lot of stuff that can happen there.
Yeah, you never know.
I mean, I think you'd be safer there than Vegas. So it was a pretty jam-packed Wednesday. I think you guys will be pretty happy with the first few minutes of this episode, which takes us to Thursday, which I know the male audience is going to be very, very happy about.
And the females, you don't know, because they're excited about the new clothes.
Yes, for sure.
We had a big-time Social Bodiez photo shoot, and it was some Blackstone Labs action, too, for PJ's special project.
Mm-hmm.
But we got a lot of stuff shot, and then we did the Lunar series release yesterday. We started, and sales have been crazy through the roof, and then we also shot our product images for the camo stuff, which is dropping very, very soon, and it will be limited edition, so you guys have to jump on it, save your money, and then when it releases, you'll be able to grab it all.
Very, very exciting stuff.
I can't wait.
I'm not going to talk too much about the black and white shoot, other than the fact that it's called black and white. You'll hear more about it, though. This is a big project I'm working on. We'll be right back. Saturday we were up in New York for the big natural party, natural body block party 2016. This is the third year in a row that they have done it, I believe, unless it's the fourth.
We've been to three.
It's a big event.
Yeah.
And I would say that this one, there was probably 2,000 or 3,000 people that came through easily during the day.
Lined up around the block. It was star-studded, fitness star-studded. And it was so hot, I had to change my shirt at one point. I was like, don't touch me to people, not because I didn't want them to touch me, because my back was so sweaty and I was embarrassed. I was a beast.
Well, it was really cool to meet all the fans and, you know, all the different kinds of fans. We had wrestling fans showing up, and there was people that wanted me to autograph the Dust Extremes for them. And it was pretty entertaining.
Yeah, I have wrestling fans that show up every year to the same event for like autographs and stuff. They're very, very faithful.
They're very, very loyal fans. Monday, we were back from New York, and I came in, and I was very impressed with the juke now being fixed. It's been all smashed up. These guys have smashed it up, and it had both of the bumpers were broken. A fender was missing. I'm like, nobody ever knows, like, why.
It wasn't me.
Yeah, so now it's looks good as new, so I'm not embarrassed when it's parked out in front for demos anymore. Happy about that. Huge thank you to my boy Fatty Daddy.
Yes.
Those guys are awesome.
Tent on,
that's Billy Yanti.
My Crossfire too, and that looks sick.
See the cat I adopted?
I didn't, I just heard about it from Sally.
Yeah, she's on my Instagram. She's really sick, so I'm leaving a little earlier to bring her to the vet. She's got some, like, I adopted a cat yesterday.
It's sick?
Yeah, it's pretty sick. It's like wheezing. So, it just got spayed like a week ago. So, I don't know, it might have got sick maybe in.
That happened to Gizmo's cat, one of the cattle or something.
But like you can hear like her breathing is like it sounds like mucus in her lungs.
Yeah.
Sounds like she's having a hard time. So I don't want to wait too long to bring her. She's a really tiny little kitty. Nobody was adopting her though.
Juke,
oh, they brought the juke back, awesome.
Cross fix, but
I owe him money for this. We didn't pay him.
I don't think.
Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah, and the back's all fixed again. Good job,
pretty quick, too. Yeah, now I just got to get him to learn how to work on Ferraris. That looks good.
Yeah, wasn't there.
And I told the guys about how I met and spoke with Rich Piana. We did not speak very much. I went over to him to make sure that he understood that the video that I made back in the day was pure satire. I don't think he remembers the video, to be honest. I kind of abandoned the story, and we did a little like icebreaker thing that for the picture. Hopefully that picture's out there somewhere. I'm too small to take pictures with him now.
I walked over to him. It was like towards the end of the day. I want to reenact it because it was pretty funny. Celeste was like, that was really weird. So I like walked over to him and I was like, hey man, I was like, I never got a chance to talk to you about the video that we did. You know, I thought it was really funny. I don't even know if you saw the video. And he was looking at me like he had no fucking clue what I was talking about, right? And he was like, I told Steve, you know, I don't want any problems. And I was like, no, I was like, it was never like meant to be like that. And that was basically his only lines until the very end. I started realizing that it was not worth me really explaining that much because I could tell he wasn't following it. Yep. So I was like, it's no hard feelings though, man. It was meant like to be funny. We even sent your wife a bunch of, you know, free clothes. So he stares at me, like he stares at me all weird like this. And then he goes, let's do one of these. And he like puts his hand up like this. So then I like go and like put my hand into his hand. And like as we're doing it, he goes, icebreaker. And somebody like took a picture and then that was it. That was literally it.
And we are having more problems with American Express, which was something that I discussed in the last episode. We've actually lost one of our platinum cards now. Goodbye to that one. And hopefully we maintain the black card situation, but it has been very frustrating.
The AMX, the new AMX account, it's over.
It's over, like?
Like it's closed as of midnight tonight.
Oh, I was going to call them after we do this video.
It can't be reopened again.
Okay. What happened with that?
It's all the tax return shit. Because you remember how you guys were sending the tax return? Mm-hmm. For some reason, the IRS kicked it back because of like an address thing. And basically, that was the deadline date. So American Express is just looking at it like, because I was like, well, I'm like, to me, I feel like it's a problem on your end. Mm-hmm. Because we were told a deadline, we submitted everything by that deadline, and now you're telling me something totally different after our cards were basically working for 1 week. And he's like, I can't change anything, and there's nothing that can be done on this account. Huh. So I was like, okay.
And then how does that affect the other?
It doesn't have anything to do with the other accounts. Okay. So,
but David is saying that the other accounts are still not working on Facebook.
Yeah, because Matt was looking into that. I don't know if they, I don't know if Facebook like bans card numbers because of attempts. Mm-hmm. I have no idea. But I know Matt was like looking into that. Hmm. So Facebook still isn't going, and Instagram pretty much got wiped out.
Looks like it. I don't know. Like
Matt was gonna see if he could, like, see if there's any way to finding the old account.
And they're not responding. Trevor has been emailing them. He showed me. You know, he's emailed them probably like 20 times. So.
Yeah, and then David was supposed to be on a call with them, and I don't think they ever called him back.
3:30 today. He's supposed to have a call with Facebook. He said.
Nice. Yeah.
What's going on? Like a month? 2 months?
2 months. Ugh. 2 months. What else did we have here?
Steve?
We did a call with Steve, and there's actually going to be a whole separate video about that call, which you guys will see and know what we're talking about.
We'll actually be wearing the same clothes because we're about to film.
Hey, Steve.
PJ, okay, so here's what I'm thinking. Tell me what's good.
All right.
We got a celestial bodies, I guess like a standee type thing.
Okay.
The image and all that. We would say keep that here, use that as a marketing tool to market the celestial bodies brand.
Mm-hmm.
And build an entire area of clothing a celestial bodies, we will send back the clothes out of necessity that you guys need it right away. Right?
Okay.
We'll send that back. We'll palletize it. You'll get it, like, I guess, in 2 or 3 days. In time to unleash the new line or whatever.
Okay.
And then, once we decorate the area, we'll look on your site, send me a breakdown of the hottest items, and we'll start ordering that stuff.
Do you want to go the route of hiring somebody specifically to work?
That's the second option I have.
Okay.
I would love, the second option is the one that requires work, because the person has to come in, I have to sit down with them, I have to interview them, and they would fully work on celestial bodies alone. They wouldn't do anything else at natural body. But that means they have to be immersed in our culture.
Mm-hmm.
You understand, like, when you see our staff, you know, we're very different than any retail staff in the country.
Yeah.
So, I don't want to hire somebody that's like, fuck everybody. I'm just, you know, I don't care about any of you people. I'm just here for Celeste.
Yeah.
We can't have that.
Of course
that's
not.
Poisonous. So, if that person comes in, they're going to probably like us anyway. Nobody has bad intentions. We'll rewire them in terms of understanding retail, but they will be fully focused on celestial bodies content and also selling celestial bodies.
Would it all be in the one big store, or would it be in all the stores?
The mega store, I think the mega store is the best platform,
mm-hmm,
because of its beauty.
Yeah.
The stores are nice, but I think the mega store should be the destination. Here's why. Because it's only one unique destination,
yeah,
for celestial bodies clothing.
I agree.
And as a result, everybody will flock to the store, and your clothing line will be synonymous with a beautiful store instead of like a ghetto-ass store that's in the middle. Like, my store in New Rochelle's nice. We keep it nice, but it's not. We're moving the store in like 2 months.
Yeah.
We make a really nice concept natural body. Then we'll put it there.
I like that idea of having it all just being in the mega store. Because what I was thinking that we could do on our end is we could put out a video that is saying that we're looking to have somebody, you know, for this position that has to come in and interview with you, and that they reach out to us perhaps with resumes, and then we send them to you based on, you know, a combination of how good the resume looks, if they have any retail experience, and then the girl herself, like how she looks as a representative of the brand.
Filter the resumes to us. So resumes, send us the very best,
yep,
and then we'll interview every one of them that's perfect.
Yeah, we'll get a bunch of them that are a waste of time. That's why I think it'll be better for us to filter them for you.
Yeah, and they have to, TJ, they can live in New York, or if they want to move, we can even interview them over the phone or on Skype, and if they want to move to New York, we can even work that out, but it's best if they live in the area.
I mean, I like it. We could really get behind this and do quite a bit. So, I mean, the company's growing like crazy. The numbers that we do are phenomenal. And girls really like trying stuff on, you know? So, being able to go to one store in the New York area where they could try it on, and us getting behind it from a marketing standpoint, you know, I think that it could be huge. And we gave a tour. I had a Blackstone Valley Nutrition, who are managed by Jody Meniere, fantastic rep for my company. Those guys are really diehard Blackstone fans. They sell a lot in their store. It was nice to give them a tour. They actually haven't tried the Sour Gummy Dust Extreme yet. I let them try some here. They loved it.
Did you sprint outside
It's all the labeling, right? Shelf talkers. That's crazy. Oh, I need one. Mind if I have one of those?
Yeah, of course. How does the isolation do for you guys?
I sold a little bit of it. It does all right.
I'm gonna send you guys home with the three ways too, with the new flavors, so you can see. Because
awesome.
We got like some really like badass flavors going with this stuff, and I can also get more aggressive with the pricing on the three way,
yeah,
of course,
right,
the blend.
Yep. Yeah.
It's kind of hard to do that with an isolate,
right,
you know.
Of
so.
Course, yeah.
It literally costs like half to make this. So, but yeah, we did the cinnamon swirl.
Oh yeah, I want
to. This one is going nuts, dude. The strawberry cheesecake, like,
yep,
girls are buying that one like crazy.
Yep.
And then the vanilla peanut butter, which can't go wrong with anything
no,
peanut butter.
Yeah, no.
But yeah, we'll send you send those home to you guys
Thank
to try.
You. Thank you. Appreciate it. And,
give you some of these.
Cool. For your customers too.
Oh, did you see these? These are hilarious. My rep James had them order these.
Oh, here it is.
Which we're just giving these away to stores now too. This Dust Extreme cup. Oh,
yeah. Buy a Dust Extreme, get a cup free.
Yeah, it has the top that comes with it.
Oh, that's dope. Yeah, no, this is cool.
Hey,
it's all about marketing.
Yeah, man.
That's really what it comes down to.
It's so much better to invest your money into shit like that than into really fucking pages and magazines.
And that's what I learned, you know, right off the bat. I tried to put like coupons in these
We did it all.
And they didn't, you know, it doesn't do anything.
We did it all with Prime. We always did everything way different with Blackstone. You know, with Blackstone, we have a page in Flex. We got a page in MD. We got a page in Iron Man.
Yeah.
The only one we don't do is Muscle and Fitness, because it's literally three times more expensive.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm going to show her now.
Yeah, I think it's better to do
gym.
Them.
The Extreme, baby. Round two. We're going to the gym after this.
Speed and Truck World.
Awesome.
Yeah, you'll be on Beauty
All
World.
Right. I can't wait.
Blackstone
Valley Nutrition, baby.
Oxford,
all the way from Mass. That's right.
And I don't know what the rest of this is, so you'll close it out.
This says, okay, so planning videos. So Eric is very good at staying on top of like getting a lot of video content out for Celestial Bodiez, and we were going over some ideas we had for trying some different stuff and getting product videos out.
So I'll probably get it done tonight.
Okay.
So that'll be done. I'm gonna try and get it done before.
Let's not release that though, right?
Which one do you want first then? I'll do those. I'll do them whatever order.
Well, I don't want to do the camo one until like the camo stuff gets released. So we don't even have it yet.
So what about Lunar?
So Lunar stuff we dropped today. Mm-hmm. So anytime.
So should I switch to doing that one first?
Which one are you doing right now?
I started camo just because the order we shot it.
Camo last. Okay. And then I should have told you that sooner. And then Lunar and then what was the other one? The black and white. So I guess that's PJ because I don't know when he wants to really release those, what we did. But definitely Lunar because those are already available. And boop. And we had some discussions about doing some different artistic stuff with some catalogs that we're going to be making because we're doing big strides and big projects. And we might have, we have a digital catalog. But we're gonna redo it because of all our new items, and we wanted to do something a little bit more artistic, which is, I think, more fun for the marketing guys and for Eric and stuff. So there will be some cool new marketing content out there, and we actually bought some new toys for the computer, some filters and some cool stuff to make things look a little more artistic.
Does Justin give you the raw pictures?
Yeah, he gives the entire...
Do you want me to try and see if I can do something like orangutan editing?
Why not? What is it gonna hurt?
You go to a site, you can get the aperture filters. It's called aperture, right? That's the Mac program for
the camera.
That would be really cool. Because I got some. I wasn't completely happy with the group shots we did, but a lot of the individual ones look really good.
I can try. I mean, I thought the video we did with him, I thought I was able to get closer to his pictures for some of them.
Yeah.
Like the outside ones were pretty close to his. So I mean, it just takes time. I can use his books as reference.
We go into Eric's office and they're just like, the books open to all the tits everywhere around
there's
his
There's like mouth. Lines connecting all of them everywhere.
He loses his mind. I think that'd be awesome. Like, what would it hurt, you know?
Yeah, I can try one. If you don't like it, we don't do it either way.
It won't make butts look any bigger. Oh, and then as I walked in the marketing area to talk about that, David said, hey, would you rather me have a elephant trunk or a giraffe neck?
Trunk or giraffe
An
neck.
Elephant trunk.
Elephant trunks Why? Are super, super handy.
It would be on your face, right?
Yeah.
to pick stuff up with, you can spray water on people that aren't doing work the right way.
Okay, well,
you can eat and smell.
Right?
It's such a strange, like...
You can, like, pick stuff up with
what
it.
She was. I mean,
it's like having another
you have
limb.
A giraffe neck, you're just, like, awkward. You can't
you asked to wear
You have no friends, your neck's all long.
Yeah.
You have to have a convertible.
Damn.
Would you rather drink a cup of your mom's period blood or your dad's sperm?
What? Dave is trying to start some form of would you rather. In my experience, would you rather is usually disgusting options, like things that you would rather like rather die than do. So we should start like a more disgusting version of that. Maybe he's just getting towards that. And that's all. That's it for me.
And that's a wrap. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more. We've got tons of video content coming out all the time. In fact, I got to go shoot some more stuff right now. So as always, for my beautiful wife, Celeste, peace out. Bye. You think this is your time?